بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful.
لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. لا
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected viewers, welcome back on the synopsis of the Taraweeh that is being recited tonight. In today's Taraweeh, we started off the Taraweeh in the third ruku of Surah Ali Imran. In the first ruku that is recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about an important point. Allah ta'ala says, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. Keep in mind the background of this verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this verse at the time of the trench, when Muslims were in poverty, Muslims were in difficulty. The entire Arabian Peninsula had gathered against the Muslims. And Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to protect the Muslims and the people of Medina, had dug a trench. And at that time, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam made predictions with regard to the future expansion of Islam. And people started mocking at Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Upon this, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam received this wahi from Allah. Tell unto the people, O Prophet of Almighty Allah, Allah is the King of all kings. Tu'til mulka man tasha. He gives kingdom to whomsoever he wishes. He takes away kingdom from whomsoever he wishes. He has his wisdom. He has his reasons why he gives people power and why he takes away power. And he gives respect. Wa tu'izzu man tasha. He gives respect to whomsoever he wishes, and he humiliates and he disgraces whomsoever he wishes. Continuing on that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also given us the key for his love. And Allah ta'ala says in the 31st verse of Surah Ali Imran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ. If you love Allah, what is the manifestation of that love? فَاتَّبِعُونِ. Follow the beloved of Allah. Follow Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah Ta'ala will love you. We are also aware that this surah is known as Surah Ali Imran. Why is it known as Surah Ali Imran? Imran is the family of Hazrat Maryam, the family of Hazrat Isa, the family of Jesus. And Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala has entitled an entire chapter on that family. Imran was the father of Hazrat Maryam. He passed away before her birth. But when she was conceived, there was a promise made, which was permissible and was in vogue at that time, that we make over the child that is going to be born in the pleasure and the service of the Almighty. فَلَمَّا وَضَعَتْهَا. And when Hazrat Maryam was born, the mother of Maryam said, إِنِّي وَضَعْتُهَا أُنْثَى. O Allah, you have granted me a female child. If you had granted me a male child, perhaps he would have served the deen better. He would have served the cause better. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so beautifully puts it, وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. The male that you are wishing for can never be comparative to this female Allah ta'ala has granted you. إِنِّي سَمَّيْتُهَا مَرْيَمْ. We have given her the name Maryam. And this shows the Muslims' respect for Maryam, for Mary, which is known as such in the Christian world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنِّي وَعِذُهَا. We will protect her and her children from the devil. This is a very interesting incident Allah makes mention in the next verse. فَتَقَبَّلَهَا رَبُّهَا بِقَبُولٍ حَسَنٍ وَأَنْبَتَهَا نَبَاتًا حَسَنًا وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا. Hazrat Maryam came in the protection that when the mother took her to Masjid Aqsa and left her to the people to look after her after they had dedicated her in the service of the Almighty, she came under the care of Hazrat Zakariya, whose wife was the maternal aunt of Hazrat Maryam. One day Hazrat Zakariya goes into the room of Hazrat Maryam and he wajada indaha rizqa. He finds out of season fruit, and he said, Ya Maryam, anna laki hada. O Maryam, where did you get this out of season fruit? It was not the time of refrigeration. She said, huwa min indillah. It is from Allah. Inna Allah yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab. Allah Ta'ala grants risk and sustenance to whomsoever he wishes. Hazrat Zakariya was of old age when he heard these beautiful words from Hazrat Maryam. He desired a child, but he found it difficult to ask Allah for a child in such an advanced age. But when he saw that Allah Ta'ala could grant out of season fruit to Hazrat Maryam, he lifted up his hand in dua. The way the Quran mentions it, and we have read it in today's Taraweeh. Rabbi habli min ladunka dhurriyatan tayyiba. Oh Allah, grant me a pious offspring. And Allah Ta'ala responded by granting him Hazrat Yahya, John the Baptist, known as such in the Christian world. Allah Ta'ala goes on to speak about the aspect of Hazrat Maryam. And remember the time when Allah Ta'ala told the angels, Inna Allah astafaki, we have chosen Maryam. We have purified her. And we have given her superiority over the woman of the world. The fascinating account of the miraculous birth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is not made mention in this chapter, but it is made mention in the 16 Juz, and inshallah we will come to that. But because of making mention of Hazrat Maryam, Allah Ta'ala speaks about Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the miracles Allah Ta'ala had granted him. And Allah Ta'ala says, أَنِّي أَخْلُقُ لَكُم مِّنَ التِّينِ كَهَيَّةِ التَّيْرَ فَأَنْفُخُ فِيهِ فَيَكُونُ تَيْرًا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. That he used to take the mold of a bird and breathe into it with the command of Allah, and it used to become alive. وَهُبْرِهُ الْأَكْمَى. He used to cure the blind and the lepers with the command of Allah, not on his own. And then it goes on to make mention with regard to Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam's miraculous birth by saying, Inna mathala Isa. O people, do not become confused with regard to the birth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Yes, it was miraculous. But Inna mathala Isa, the example of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, in the eyes of Allah, is like the example of Hazrat Adam. If the birth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was miraculous, if he was born without a father, and that is a miracle, then Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was born without the agency of a male and a female. And Allah Ta'ala says, how did I bring them into existence? خَلَقَهُ مِن تُرَابَ. I created them from dust. And then I told them, come. And they became. It was the command of Allah. Continuing, then Allah Ta'ala says, قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا إِسَى. And we told unto Isa, we will take you in full towards Almighty Allah. And that is a belief of the Muslims. That Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was not killed or crucified in this world, but he was taken up in full by the Almighty. And that is why the surah is known as Surah Al-Imran, the surah of the family of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Then continuing on there, there are other many beautiful verses. Allah Ta'ala in verse 71 of Surah Al-Imran speaks about a pledge Allah Ta'ala took from all the prophets of yore. And Allah Ta'ala says, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ. And Allah Ta'ala took a pledge from all the prophets of the past. If their time in this world coincided with the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they must leave their call and they must bear testimony to the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Because our beloved Nabi was not only the Nabi of this Ummat, he was also Nabiul Anbiya, the Nabi of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Continuing on there, in the Taraweeh today, we started off the fourth juz of the Holy Quran. And Allah starts off the fourth juz of the Holy Quran with these beautiful words. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will not achieve righteousness and closeness to Allah until you learn to spend in the path of Allah that which you love. Until you cannot sacrifice what you love for the sake of Allah, how will you gain the love of the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? On the very first page of this juz, the fourth juz, Allah Ta'ala speaks about Makkah, the house in Makkah, the house of the Almighty Allah in Makkah. But Allah Ta'ala very beautifully says the objective of the Baytullah. The first house Allah established in this earth, in that Allah Ta'ala says, it is Mubarak wa Huda. It is blessed and a hidayat and guidance for people. Every masjid that is constructed should strive to achieve these objectives of blessedness and hidayat for the people who come to that masjid and for its neighborhood. Allah Ta'ala also goes on to make mention of the high rank and responsibility of this ummah in the 110th verse of Surah Ali Imran by saying, Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. You are the best of people whom we have created. But why are you the best of people? With that privilege comes a responsibility. What is that responsibility? تَعْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ You command people to do good and you prevent them from evil. That is a feather in your cap. That is the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the rank of being the best of ummats, the best of people. Then as we continue in this surah and also what was recited in this Taraweeh today, Allah Ta'ala speaks about two battles. Allah Ta'ala speaks about the battle of Badr. And Allah Ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ نَصْرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرِ وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّةٌ And recall the time when Allah Ta'ala assisted you in the battle of Badr. وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّةٌ When you were weak. And therefore, always keep this in mind. إِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا Whenever you persevere upon the commands of Allah and you have taqwa, the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always follow you. The way it followed the people and the companions at the time of the Battle of Badr. Keep these two keys in mind. In tasbiru wa tattaqu, if you persevere and you always have the taqwa and the fear of the Almighty, none can harm you. From the second quarter of the fourth juz, the fourth part of the Holy Quran, Allah Ta'ala speaks about the Battle of Uhud. We are all aware that the Battle of Uhud was one of the major battles in the time of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It was a remarkable battle. In the beginning stages of the battle, Muslims were gaining victory. And because of misunderstanding one of the commands of our beloved Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, a certain victory was turned into a setback. And in the second quarter of this juz, Allah Ta'ala refers to that setback in such a beautiful way. Allah Ta'ala first goes on to make mention, you had made a mistake. The Prophet of Almighty Allah told you to remain steadfast on a place. You misunderstood the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because of that, Allah Ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ أَفَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ Allah has forgiven your mistake. Then Allah Ta'ala tells us, learn from your mistake. Thus we find, قُلْتُمْ أَنَّ هَذَا At the end of the battle, you started asking one another the question. Why did the setback take place? Allah Ta'ala says, هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ Look at your own self. Whenever anything goes wrong, then always introspect. Why did it go wrong? So we learn the aspect of introspection. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the sahaba and the companions of the time glad tidings. Don't ever lose hope at the time of a setback. Allah Ta'ala says, إِيَمْسَسْكُمْ كَرْهُنْ If you have suffered losses or if you have suffered a wound, the people whom you have fighted and also suffered losses. And وَلِتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامِ These are the days which Allah Ta'ala sometimes bring about easy conditions, sometimes victory, sometimes difficult conditions. Don't get overawed by that. Always keep your focus towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala says, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا Don't lose hope. Do not become grieved. You would be victorious if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It also, this whole particular aspect of the battle of Uhud teaches us steadfastness. Because during the battle, the rumor came that Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had passed away. And he was martyred. And Allah Ta'ala says, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ Muhammad is the Rasul of Almighty Allah. There were many prophets of the past. أَفَإِمَّاتَ If he dies, or if he is killed, are you going to turn away from religion? No. You cannot turn away from religion because as important as Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is, we worship Allah and we don't worship Muhammad. So the second juz of the holy of the fourth supara is so important in that it teaches us the way of coming back after a setback. And then towards the end of this most beautiful chapter, Allah Ta'ala, you know, relates certain du'as that we can always read. And I would like to conclude and really draw your attention to these beautiful du'as that we can always bring into our life. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا Oh Allah, you have not created us, you have not created the universe in vain. Oh Allah, save us from the fire of Jahannam. إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارِ Whoever you put in the fire of Jahannam, he would be a base. رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيَي يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ Oh Allah, we have brought Iman upon the caller who called us towards faith. And we brought Iman upon him. رَبَّنَا فَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا Oh Allah, because of that, forgive and overlook our shortcomings. And وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ And let us die with those people who are righteous. Oh Allah, whatever promises you have made, it is true. We believe in that. وَلَا تُغْزِنَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Oh Allah, do not disgrace us on the day of Qiyamah. Do not disgrace us in this world. Do not disgrace us in the hereafter. With these beautiful words of dua, which we read in the last ruku of today's Taraweeh, it is a befitting end for today's synopsis of the Taraweeh that was recited.